The Kansas City Repertory Theatre has a new artistic director, and he's young. Eric Rosen comes to us from Chicago, and we caught up with him to see what he has in mind for Kansas City Theatre.
I'm a university guy from way back. I did a PhD at Northwestern in the 90s, and have taught for years at both Northwestern, University of Chicago, other places. So I've been really reared as a teacher and as an instructor, and really passionate about education. And the opportunity to come work at the Rep was made much more attractive to me by the opportunity to help lead the theater program and collaborate with the theater faculty in the training of young designers and young actors. And that to me is really important, that the theater honor its founding, which was really as a university theater and as a center of the UMKC community. I'm mostly known as a guy who develops new plays. I'm a playwright and a director, and I also collaborate with a lot of playwrights and directors on creating new stories. So in my career so far, I've directed about 40 plays, of which 33 or 34 have been world premieres, often developed with a playwright in the room, or sometimes I've been the playwright. So we're going to be creating work in that model that I've gotten really passionate about over the years here in Kansas City. There hasn't been an extant whole new play development initiative at the Rep in the past several years.
Some of the new plays Eric hopes to develop might eventually show up here at the Rep's second theater, the Copagan Stage. It opened in spring 2007, marking the company's first time in an off-campus location.
Kansas City Repertory Theater really wanted more than one stage because having two different venues really allows you to do a much greater variety of artistic work. The board of directors was really committed to the role that the Rep could play in the heart of the city. So we began looking, and we found out that H&R Block had made the decision to put their world headquarters downtown, which was a great decision for Kansas City, and that they were going to have a training auditorium in that space. And so we went to them and said, well, how about not a training auditorium? How about a real state-of-the-art theater? And they said, yes, we think that can work.
Stages like the Copacan are designed to give both the sense of intimacy that you want for a smaller play, but in this case, I think just the beautiful design of this theater is that it still feels like an epic world-class stage.
And on the Rep's epic stages, beginning in September, Eric will present Kansas City audiences with the plays he's selected.
You only get a first season once. You know what I mean? To make an introduction. And so I've really tried to put together a body of work and a group of artists who reflect the things I'm most passionate about and the visions and points of view so that people who can come to the theater for any one show will get a sense of what's in store for us over the next few years. We're returning to the work of Mary Zimmerman, who wrote Metamorphoses. Mary is one of the five or six best theater artists in the country, deeply imaginative, has a beautiful visual style, and we're creating a production of her play, The Arabian Nights, based on 1001 Arabian Nights. It has a gorgeous, multicultural, fantastic cast of 15, live music, one of the most beautiful plays I've ever seen in my lifetime. Another major project that's coming up is the Kansas City premiere of August Wilson's last play, Radio Golf. And as Kansas City audiences know, August Wilson had a really special relationship with Kansas City. And in fact, this was his last play. He finished it while he was here in residence working on a production of Two Trains Running. And it's really moving to me that he was here and took some inspiration from this city. And this play will reflect really well for Kansas City audiences. And it's a really big responsibility to be a young leader of a major institution and to represent the next wave of leadership and really thinking about what regional theater is for and what it means for theater to sit down in a community and yet push the American theater forward. And for me, the big dream, and I think it's important to have them, is that Kansas City is going to become a major theater town, and that we're going to create the best work, and that Kansas City Repertory Theater is going to be listed in the top five theater companies in North America, outside of New York and Chicago.